I'll do. Ooh, yeah.
I wanna set you up. TikTok it up.
Make it up until we drown.
TikTok it up.
Anyway, we here, man. Happy Friday to all, and to all a good day. It's your boy Willie B. Hopefully everybody got some stimulus money. You know, my banking situation is crazy, so I gotta wait. I'm on the back burner with that type of business. But anybody who did get that bread, man, enjoy. You know, it's about damn time. Enjoy yourself, pay your bills, do whatever you gotta do. Feed your kids, you know, pay your debts. Whatever, to just get your mental back into a space where you can be productive. Tonight we got one of those like get it out the mud. This is the true definition of get it out the mud. Master P. Out of New Orleans, Louisiana. The oldest of five kids. He's got a couple notable brothers. Guy by the name of C. Murder, who has been locked up forever. Ever since I've ever heard of this guy, he's been locked up. And Silk the Shocker, who I didn't know was his brother either. He was a ball player, basketball player in high school. Really good one, too. He went to the University of Houston on a basketball scholarship. So he was already destined to get out of the hood. So a few months after his freshman year, he drops out. And then transfers to Merritt College in Oakland, California. He majored in business administration. While he was in California, he opened up a music shop, and it was called No Limit Records. That was like the kind of the foundation of his label. You know, he had had the West Coast tie. He already had the hood kind of on his back and supporting him and seeing him as the next big thing. But now he's connecting coasts, you know. Started recording and pressing out his own shit on cassette tapes. Which leads us to his debut album, which he released in 1991, which we're doing today. It's called Get Away Clean. He's a true teacher in consistency. He's a true teacher in work ethic. Even to this day, he's got his hands in things, and he's always answering the call of opportunity. And that's the biggest thing for a lot of people, because we all can have a lot of things that we want, but we usually just miss that call of opportunity, or squander it, or we scared of the moment. Now, in my life, I didn't get Master P until later on when he started, you know, really putting out Silk the Shocker and Mr. Cool, you know, in the whole No Limit rollout. So let's deep dive in.
Man, that's a fucking rerun. Turn the TV off, man. Turn the radio on, man. Turn the radio on.
Starting off with Familiar Vibes, Sanford and Son. I got on Sanford and Son when I was young. I forget what channel they used to play that on, but I'd catch it. And Red Fox, I liked the show. It felt like it was too old for me. It was like that dirty, antique kind of house that, you know, it was like your grandparents' house where, you know, shit was still dusty. You could tell it was whole hemispheres of the house that was unoccupied. That feeling of just old collectible hoarder shit, that's what that show gave me vibes of. But as I got older, I started to respect Red Fox comedy, and I started to see the genius in it. But
drop it from the master to the crowd that surrounds me. Once the king speaks, you suckers better bow to your highness. Royalties and jewels, I stole your chick. Punk motherfuckers wanna get flicked like a bitch, sucker. I'm just fiending to kick some ass.
So it's interesting, they come in with these hip hop samples that, you know, if you listen to hip hop for years, you're familiar with. But then his rhymes, the way Master P come in, he's different. He's different from anybody that's out. Because the way he cuts through a record, it's almost like he's making the record match him. He's not like rapping on the beat. He's like just rapping and then hoping the beat, you know, catches up. Feels pimp talkish, you know. He's young, but it feels like he knows, you know, the streets for sure. His man, he got featured on it. He come in with that old, like, motherfucking Cool in the Gang type shit. He coming with that ooh, and this is 91, so that shit is kind of played out, like this kind of style he coming in with. Off the samples, it can fly.
Sitting in the project trying to get my game on. Fuck these hoes, they just ding dongs. Mama needs shoes, baby need milk, so I gotta get scrapped with a knife for some bullshit.
You know, they just pretty much took the Run DMC beat Run's house and just nabbed the beat, and he rapped on it for a few seconds. And by this point in 91, the flows are really starting to evolve. But you got to remember where he from and how they get it down there. They are forced to, like, they were kind of behind in that flow, so they had to create a whole new flow. And that's why that down south has elevated so high, because yeah, they saw what New York was doing and they saw what LA was doing and everywhere else, and you know, they was like, all right, but we're gonna start from scratch and make our own shit and then grow that and make that the biggest thing ever.
Ooh, I'm with it. Smooth. If you a sucker, you better move on. The CP is just flowing with the microphone.
What makes this really inventive and cool for this time is that nobody was really doing this. Ice Cube was playing around with it. I mean, other artists was kind of doing it, but, you know, to be able to take somebody's beat who wasn't rapping on it. Like, he's taking Rick James, who sang on the beat, but taking that same beat but rapping on it. It's, like, new. It's, like, if you, any record you can get to like that, it's a new thing, because we've only heard the ballad version of it, or the, you know, R&B soul version of it. That's why sometimes I gotta watch these dope dealers and these hustlers, the way they make music, because sometimes they don't give, they package it like it's drugs, you know, they just push that shit out. The production is actually a little dope on this, the transitions throughout the end, and then you kind of get that, you know, that Rakim beat that come in on the end. I think it's Microphone Fiend. He just talking shit. They're just shouting people out and talking about the hood. But that's genesis of hip-hop. You know, before niggas was doing whole verses, a nigga would just get on the mic and just shout out his homies. Like, that's how rapping started. It was no, like, metaphors and wordplay and pun. It was always wordplay, but, like, not like storytelling necessarily. The story they were telling was the one where they were at. You know what I mean? They're telling what's happening. They like shawty with the blue dress, drunk dude in the back with this shit, my homie right here, RIP to this dude. You know, it's like, it's all about what's happening in the moment.
I'm gone, had to lose the low, ducking and dodging, moving focus through the tracks, so the beats out low, not moving at a fast pace. Well, gosh, just be hump, man, no way, it's time to make my move, jump in the groove, had a cops on the drill, yo, what you gonna
do? So crazy, this is like him showing, hey, I could do what y'all New York niggas do too. It's like, kind of fast paced, got some New York, you know, some early samples in there that, you know, New York rappers use. The quality of it is kind of shiesty, you know, but I like it. It kind of goes with Master P and where he at right now, because he's just getting it out the mud, bro. You know what I mean? And so they figuring out how to record it, but the sound isn't the best on this particular record. He's showing a different side of himself on it. Of course, it's not my favorite. I don't expect him to try this style, but I respect him for trying it. So, Crooked Ass Law. This is a lot of what we talk about, you know? And not to say that, you know, racism is the number one thing. Obviously, the number one thing is, like, humans are fucked up. We fuck each other over. So the fact that we bring it to the law being twisted, you know, a lot of people can bend the law. It's black people involved in the law who could bend the law. So a lot of white people involved in it who could bend the law. It's just being on that side of it. You know, if you work at McDonald's, you bend the law at McDonald's. So it's the same type of concept, you know. So who's gonna get fucked over when you feeling like, oh, I need to fuck somebody over, or when you got an uncontrollable itch of fucking motherfuckers over? A lot of people choose black purposely. Like, I'm gonna do black because somehow I feel something that they deserve it, or that.
Yo, man, what's up? You know what I'm saying? We want the fucking boys. I'm about to get fucked wild and go stupid ass motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? We get cool and shit, y'all show niggas.
This crew out on this, true. Not really my taste. You know, it's just one of them kind of records that you gave to the homies that it didn't really pop. I can't say that about my homies, though. I got a record with my homies that actually is that gas. And matter of fact, we need to put that out. Clap Anthem, fellas. We need to assemble on that and make that happen.
I made my move and I can't be stopped, because I'm the type of brother that keeps rising to the top. Jack of old jam and that hella bass. See, I pass it up with the 808.
What about Master P that I'm learning right now? Because, like, his rhymes ain't even the best to me. You know, the production is spotty. But, you know, maybe I'm encapsulated because I know how great he is as a person. But it even translates on this record, like early P, like, because what he's saying, it ain't like he says some bullshit in there for sure. But, like, you hear his intelligence even in his bullshit. Even though it's like a lot of bullshit he say, but like he say a lot of just whatever shit, like street shit that you don't think applies, but it actually does, you know. I think that's the genius of him. You think that he's wasting bars, but he's really not. The more I kind of listen in on him, so many samples on here. I mean, so far, like he's used like 20 samples, and then it's only been 6 songs. I see why this album is called Getaway Clear.
Oh fuck, I like it like that, but I want without my lubricating genie hat. It's so cool, that's no doubt. If she wanna take the sponge, she gonna have to turn her purple like the inside out.
I ain't gonna lie, this Dana record, it's only a matter of seconds, but this is my favorite one because he chose this old jazz sample to rap on, which is like so hip-hop of Master P, and that tells me pretty much everything I need to know about Master P. The fact that he chose that and rapped on that, he probably fought to just do that, you know what I mean? Like, people probably weren't even feeling that, but he was like, no, I'm gonna do it. Like, you could tell that Master P is, he's so different, but he's still that like hip hop kid.
Well, I met, man.
Well, why Tootsie looking this?
Nah, man, I'm telling you.
Another one of them freaky tails.
Man, a fucking freaky tail, yeah, man. This girl's name, Dana. You can bang her, man.
Oh, yeah, y'all down south niggas is freaky. Y'all openly freaky. Cause he talking about Dana. He talking about, you know, Dana a hoe, and she out here fucking, and she only like big dicks. He talking about a chick using honey to eat his ass. Y'all code like that. Y'all do it. See, me, I'm open like that, but like, it's, you know, not a lot of people, you know, in my area be like that. Don't let they freak out like that. Yeah, we're just talking about Dana. She's a hoe. See, I mean, I love a hoe. I praise a hoe. Hoes, any girl who's a hoe, do not be ashamed, you know, because those days will come to an end. Like, you can't hoe forever, you know. Hoe comes to a bitter end. But, you know, hoe it out. Get it out your system. You know, hoe that shit out. Men too, hoe it out. No, I love a hoe. Just don't try to settle down with me. When you could add me in the admin of hoeage, but don't just keep it moving.
But yo, it doesn't matter who this girl you make. Master P got with him in the casket. It was from California, but it's got to be taken. But it's outside, north of Rochester, but you better step a deck.
It's funny, I just played this one at the beginning. They sampled Color Me Bad. From the sample selections through this whole thing, like, I already got, you know, Master got my respect.
Mine, cause I'm the jack of the jackal. Cause I'm the jack of the jackal. Cause I'm the jack of the jackal. Cause I'm the jack of the jackal.
Alright, we here. This is why I came to this album, right here for this song. This shit is hard, bruh. It's got that menacing beat. This feels like the area that P should be in right here. And P is so eclectic. That's what I'm learning from him. He loves everything.
Cause I'm a jack of the jackers. Cause I'm a jack of the jackers.
Right now, Master P got a little Ice Cube in him. I think Master P is an Ice Cube baby. Cause everybody got usher ins. You got an usher in artist. Mine is Wale and fucking Kanye. You know, I get those are like my usher ins. Eminem is a usher in of mine.
Get large on these motherfuckers, you know what I'm saying? And these motherfucking robust type ass niggas, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Suck my dick, you know what I'm saying? Cause I jack them up in a minute, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, but check this out. I think that bitch say, you know, she's gonna be over at the motherfucking.
Nigga knows, man. Shout out to Michael Jackson. Shout out to Double A Stacks, my boy, my beat maker. This nigga, man, he sampled this record for me early on my first project. When she says hello to the world. Bananas. Double A Stacks, you know what I mean? Now, he just talked, it's almost like a celebration, you know? He just letting that song play, and he just talking in the background like, yo, we just made a bunch of money off this lick. We about to hit another one, like, life is good. It's just showing you the upside of the drug dealer game, you know what I mean? When you hustling, he's already converted into making the music, you know, and that's his hustle. Man, I got money in my pocket. Shit went well.
Yo, Silk Man, pass me a 40. Are you ready to do this shit or what?
Like, I get it on this song, and some people really like this song. It's not my favorite flavor. But he's figuring it out, man. He's figuring it out. kind of, he knows how to put a song together is what this tells me. Even though it's not a song that I'm going to listen to again, but, you know, this sounds like some shit that New Orleans would get up for, because it's got those early New Orleans, like, sound. They got a lot of, like, they made funeral music dope in New Orleans. Like, they made organs, like, niggas playing the organ really dope. They know how to, like, because there's so much death and crime and shit, they just learned how to incorporate that because into their hip-hop. This is amazing. That's the genius of the South. They take the bullshit that you don't care about, and they flip it, and they make it great.
And we're sitting here with rap star Master P, lead up the Real Untouchables. Master P, where are you from?
The ghetto.
Now that you're living in Beverly.
The ghetto.
Hills, have anything changed?
Well, not really.
Master P, would you like to say anything to the people who didn't think you could make it?
Yeah, fuck them.
So, Master P, what's life to you?
Life to me ain't nothing but bitches and money.
Life.
We sampled Rick James again. Cold-blooded. I like that record, too. And I actually really like the way he's spitting on this one. This is actually a dope record right here. You say life ain't nothing but women and money. You know, I feel them because those are big. Those are two things that really matter to me. All the women in my life and having some money. You know, those two things really do matter. But it's more that matters in life. I think really the biggest thing is just helping people out. That's kind of the biggest thing that matters. You know, seeing beyond yourself, taking care of yourself, but seeing beyond yourself to help other people. That's the biggest, you know, sacrifice. That's the biggest anything that matters. You know, when you have children, it's thinking about somebody other than yourself. When somebody's in trouble, it's thinking about somebody beyond yourself. That's the biggest, I think, merit you can ever do. And that, you know, that's beyond money or some pussy.
Hey,
I know that cry. I know that cry. That's when a mother cries when her son or daughter dies, man. It's usually the son. It's always the saddest shit in the world to me. I've been on the phone. I've been in person with a mother crying when her son or daughter dies. It's traumatizing. It's the worst thing ever. Well, come on, P, let's get high. He like, nigga, you don't even do that. Like, P don't even get high. So that tell you how focused my man was. You know what I mean? Especially at that time. Because, see, that's the thing that weed can do. Weed can, like, get you off your focus if you ain't mastered the process, you know? Talking about Master P, you would think Master P smoke a bunch of weed, but he just speaking all of the knowledge right here on this record that he possibly had. He's like, I'm giving y'all just as much real knowledge. This is the first time I ever heard P talk about philosophy, black ideology, any of that shit. He's talking about Farrakhan. He's talking about a lot of shit on this record. So it shows you album concept and theme. I thought it was going to be so I thought I was going to give this a super low rating because I didn't think it translated, but it actually does. And you got to think about it on a deep level because the amount of samples that this nigga used on this record is ungodly. And there's no way he would have been able to pay that much. And I'm sure that at this time they weren't so heavy on charging for samples maybe in 91, but he got away clean. Maybe he knew that, yo, this shit I'm doing right now, I can get away with it right now. Like, I think he's that type of nigga who just, he smells a trend, he smells a thing, and he knows when to get in and get out. He's a real businessman that is in hip-hop, that can actually that actually loves a lot of really good hip-hop artwork. It's very dope. I love early artwork because it seems you get closer to the artist usually on their first album artwork. The rest of them starts to get super artsy fartsy and abstract, but that first one is usually the rawest, and I like the rawness of this. It's these niggas like jumping over the gate. Everybody can kind of relate to this if you from the hood or from a hood or from where, you know, our communities usually branch to, because even the suburbs become the hood in black communities because we, you know, you can't get the hood out of us. We have that mentality sometimes. But I love this because it looks like me and my boys. It looks like me and my friends back in the day. Just hopping fences and doing crazy, you know, just crazy shit, man. Whatever. Just trying to have some fun. I like the binocular look. It's got the binocular frame. It's like on some getaway shit. It adds up. I really like it. I'm gonna give it an 8. Production on this, I give production credit because of the samples, like the sample choices. There's a lot of great sample choices. They didn't really do a lot of flipping of those beats. Some of them they flip, but some of them they just let ride. And you know, production was a little low quality, a lot of low quality, but I'm not trying to hold that against him because this is his first album and this is a nigga who got it out the motherfucking trenches, man. Creativity, the biggest creativity I give my man on this is just the sample selection. And I can't stress that enough because in early hip hop that mattered the most. And that just showed me how eclectic he was musically. Replay value is on the lower side for me, but there is value here. I mean, there's no doubt about it. There's value here on the sides of the way Master P kicked it. He's like a different version of Ice Cube. But then more than that, just his ear and what he allowed to go through on this record. His skits were very good. It's cultural. It feels like it's something you can connect to for sure. On this, you know, macro level, it's a 4. Impact to the game and the culture, I think, is a little on the higher scale because he's doing things that I don't think people knew you can do, you know, on that scale, especially being from New Orleans. I think he really broke the mold with the way he came out. Because nobody would probably know how to come out. You know, you need a Master P who goes into those distant grounds and search new land and create, you know, what is the, you know, sound for down south. Now, it's people who came out from New Orleans before him. And I got to get to him. Trust me, I didn't gloss over him. That's why I stay in the past, because I don't want to miss anybody. Circle head, but I'm able to definitely see genius in all types of lyrics, all types of hip hop forms. And with his lyrics, you know, it seems like he's a chip off the Ice Cube block, which he really get off sometimes. That's a good block to be off, you know. But, you know, this album isn't necessarily a lyrical explosion, but he gives you so much game and realness through it that it carries it. His realness carries this album, other than like his super artsy fartsy way of attacking shit. I'm gonna go with a 5. All right, so this album scored a 41. You know, that's an album that's gotta grow on you. You know, the reason why it's so fitting is because, you know, Master P is different. You haven't heard anything like this. And whenever somebody's taking you into a new direction of rhyming and beats and things, you kind of like a direction you've never heard, you know, you might be a little turned off from your favorite because it doesn't hit your favorite because it's different. They're not trying to do your favorite. They're trying to do something other than your favorite. You put this magical moments in this album for anybody who knows hip hop and love hip hop. You can immediately identify the moments. I'll give you 2 records that I absolutely love. The record What's Up With That, my favorite record on the whole project. I have to listen to it. He brought it so much. This is like quintessential Master P. If he could do a whole album of records like that, it's a wrap. Second song, Bitches and Money. I just love it. I love it, love it, love it, love it, love it, love it, love it.